Hey guys, it's Adriana here from AdDoLab, and today I'm going to talk to you about image SEO. I'm going to be talking about how to start showing up on Google Images. And don't worry if you don't know anything about image SEO, I'm going to explain every step on how you can start ranking on the first page of Google and showing up as an image. So today we're going to be talking about like a product. Just for an example, I think it's easier to talk about an e-commerce store and how you can start ranking for your products on Google Images. So the reason that you would want to show up on Google Images is this is a really great way to find customers. Not only are you in front of your new shoppers, your new prospective customers, but also these are people who are interested in buying this product. After all, they are the ones who typed it into Google search bar. So this is a really great way to drive traffic, because if someone's interested in a product that you're selling, then they can click on that image. Or if it's a blog article, it might be a blog topic. They click on that, then they're gonna go straight directly to your website. And this is amazing because Google's driving traffic to your website, and this is free advertising. So you can use Google Images as a way to get new visitors to your website without paying a single dime. So this is really incredible, especially if you're a new website just starting out and you don't have a lot of money to throw thousands of dollars on advertising, then definitely utilize image SEO. So we're going to go over the different steps that you would want to take in order to start ranking. So one of the best ways to rank on Google Images is to start ranking for keywords. So you might wonder, how did these people show up when I type in a certain search phrase? How did these people pop up on Google Images? And the answer is they are ranking for keywords. And a keyword is just a search phrase or term. So an example might be purple pajama pants. This is something someone might type into Google, and then Google's going to show them images that are related to this search query. So Google's trying to answer what you're looking for. They're trying to show you something that you're looking for. So people are ranking for terms, and that's how they show up on Google Images. So if you want to show up on Google Images, then you need to rank for terms. And the way you do this is through keyword research. Now, you can do this by using Google AdWords, which is actually free. And the idea here is that you want to look for a term that has low competition, meaning it's not highly competitive. You're not, you know, competing against Amazon and Walmart for short keywords like shoe or something really broad. You're trying to rank for a keyword that is really specific. So something that has low competition, low hanging fruit. And then you also want to rank for a keyword that people are actually searching for. It needs to have search volume or traffic. So you want to make sure that you're looking for a keyword that has low competition and a decent search volume. If that makes any sense, don't worry. If it doesn't, you can go to our article on how to research keywords. I'll put a link down below. All right, so now that you have your keyword and you've researched it, what do you do with it? So you want to make sure that you use this keyword throughout your web page. So if you have a product that you're selling, then that means this keyword will be in the product title, it'll be in the page title, the meta description, the product description. And this leads me to my next point. So one of the best ways to start ranking on Google Images is by making sure that you fill in your alt text. Now, image alt text is alternative text, and it helps Google understand what you're selling or what it is in that image, because Google is a blind robot and they cannot see your image. This is one of the best tips that I give people, is make sure that you realize that Google can't see your image. So you're gonna have to signal to them with written words what it is exactly. For alt text, you want to make sure that you use your keyword that you've researched one time. You don't want it to repeat over and over and over again. So if you have, for example, a product and you have 10 images on that product, you want to use your keyword one time. And then for the other images, the other 9 images, you want to say something different and similar, but definitely different. You don't want to repeat yourself. And the reason for this is because Google doesn't want to get spammed with your keyword a million times. They'll think that you're trying to game the system, and they don't like that, so they might bury you in search results. So it's much better to actually manually type in your alt text and describe what's in that image in readable human language, And this helps Google understand what your image is about. It helps other people understand what your image is about. And it's just a win-win situation. A lot of people, we know a lot of customers have used other SEO apps that are not so great. And what they do is they fill in your alt text automatically by repeating your product title. And this is terrible and can actually lower your SEO ranking on Google. So definitely don't fall into that trap. And the way that you would format your alt text is just how you speak normally. So if I want to name my image purple pajama pants, I would just write that purple pajama pants for women, something like that. And you don't need to put hyphens, and that's all you need to do. All right, so that brings me to my last point about file names. So what is a file name? A file name is the name that you give to a file. So if you're taking pictures on your camera will just give you some default file names such as, you know, img_02193. It's just rubbish, it means nothing. And so you wanna make sure that if you're, you know, putting those images onto your website, that you actually change it from the default name to something that makes more sense. And the reason for this is you want to help Google understand what's on your website. And they can't do that if you just give them a file name with a bunch of numbers that means nothing. You want to make sure that you're giving Google something to work with. So if it's a picture of purple pajama pants, let them know that by naming your file name with your keyword one time. So you want to use your keyword one time on a product page. And then if you have lots of other images, it falls into the same rules with the alt text. You want to make sure to name those other file names something different. Everything needs to be unique, and Google loves unique content. So make sure you don't spam them by putting your keyword a million times on all your images for the file names. But definitely do name your files something unique and something that makes sense, that Google can make sense of your images that you're giving them. And this is a great way to start ranking on Google Images. And I have an example down below. I'll put a link. I have a whole article tutorial on how to rank on Google for Google Images with an example of purple pajama pants, which we've been speaking about in this video tutorial. So definitely take a look, and it has a step-by-step guide on how to see alt text on your own images. And also, if you use our app, Get Clicked SEO, we have a feature on there where you can see all your missing alt text and you can fill them in and see anything wrong with them as well. So in summary, this is just one little piece of the pie. There are over 200 ranking factors for Google, and your image SEO optimizations is just one little piece of this pie. So you want to make sure that you just keep doing all the right things so that you can start ranking higher. You know, you want to make sure that you do this because it is a positive step in the right direction. And who knows, it definitely could lead to being on the first page of Google Images. So just make sure you keep doing all the right things, making all the right choices, and keep working hard on your website because every little bit counts. So I hope that this has been a really informative video for you and that you've learned a lot, and you're gonna go tackle your own website and optimize it right now, because that's always a good thing to do. And if you have any questions or any comments and tips on how to optimize your own images, definitely leave those down below in the comments field. And make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, guys, if you want to see more SEO tips. All right, bye. We'll see you guys next time.